There's so many things in this play that, even with it being 1600s and early America and Puritan times, it's still, there's a lot that rings true to modern times, how people are very hypocritical of pointing out other people's wrongdoings and not rectifying or being repentant of their own.
It's one of those plays where it's a little bit harder to find the joy. Just like sometimes in life, it's hard to find the joy in the small moments.
Anytime someone sees her, they have to look at the Scarlet Letter, and basically she has to answer for her sin anytime someone sees it.
In the eyes of men and in the sight of God.
There's a verse in Genesis. Joseph is talking to his brothers after they found out he's a Pharaoh, after they've sold him into slavery. And what he says to his brothers, he's like, "What you intended for evil, God used for good." I think that's echoed in a lot of what happens, especially towards the end. Though there is this concept of, I would say, God giving us a blessing in the midst of our anguish.
You'll get to know a classic story, and you'll have a really good time.
It's just a beautiful message to remind you to not point fingers at other people when you're not perfect.